Well, yesterday it was Liberal MP John McCollum who was on the line with those CAW workers in Oshawa. Today it was NDP leader Jack Layton and his team showing solidarity. Mr. Layton, the union is talking about fair trade and they pointed a finger at Korea. Can you explain for our audience what's happening with Korea especially and the automobile industry?
Sure. Well, let's put it this way. The agreement that's being looked at would have us send our Canadian raw materials to Korea, and their cars would come into Canada. But our cars couldn't make it into Korea. And that's simply wrong. I mean, that's nuts to sign a trade deal like that. We don't want to go back to being just...
So we're going to have a trade deal which...
Hewers of wood and drawers of water, Mike. That's essentially where they'd like to leave us. We lost 30,000 full-time jobs just in the month of May in Canada. We've got a real crisis there. They were replaced by 40,000 part-time jobs. That doesn't pay a mortgage.
So what do you think the union can do in the next little while? General Motors seemed pretty adamant today. They weren't interested in talking.
Yeah, it was very disappointing, and I met with the union leadership there at the Oshawa site, and there's no question they were discouraged. But on the other hand, I think that it's time for Canadians to rally around these workers, because if you think about it, they're kind of on the tip of the iceberg, because there's 1,000 workers there, their families. These are the backbone of a typical Canadian community like Oshawa, where those are the people, the middle class, who pay the bills, who support the local hockey team, the local church, the local Rotary Club when they do their fundraisers, United Way. And they're losing their jobs and ending up with part-time work if they're lucky. And the fact is that we've had almost 250,000 jobs of that kind lost in the last very few years in Canada. And it's leaving us in a very vulnerable situation, and our community is really struggling. So I hope that people will get behind these workers, because in a sense, they're on the forefront of saying, what's gone wrong with our economic strategy here? We've signed all these free trade deals, but it looks like the big multinational corporations don't really even respect their contracts. Where's law and order Flaherty when we need him? He should be standing up for these contracts.
This is the thing that I find quite bizarre, that 2 weeks ago, General Motors signs this big agreement looking ahead several years, everything's fine, and then all of a sudden, as if they haven't seen the increase in oil prices, all of a sudden they say, no, we're not just going to cut back, we're actually going to shut down a billion-dollar plant that is, according to their own estimates, the most modern and most productive in the world.
It strikes me as being
really bizarre. And the other thing that strikes me politically, if I may put on my political hat for a minute, wouldn't this be, we saw what the Prime Minister did with RadarSat and not allowing it to be sold to the Americans, wouldn't this be the kind of cause that he could pick up on the whole question of Canadian nationalism, given General Motors' track record?
That's exactly what I called on him to do today, Mike. You're absolutely right. And just as we urged him to do the right thing with the sale of that Keystone space-aged company that was putting the RadarSat system together and the Canada arm and everything else, this is a key place for him to intervene. And I call on him to do so. Put aside the rhetoric here and start to understand that the key manufacturing sectors in our economy need to be recast. They need to be reconstructed with the help of the government on a strategic basis to get into the 21st century, the new energy economy, energy efficiency, the best possible designs to achieve that. That's what Canadians are looking for. We've called for it for years. I remember 4 years ago standing with the CAW and Greenpeace and laying out a full green car strategy for Canada. If only governments would embrace this vision. This is where Canadians want us to go, and this plant was supposed to be producing a hybrid truck. I mean, we're going to need some trucks in our society, probably as long as you and I can imagine. Why not have them be the most energy efficient and made right here in Canada? And yet GM turned its back on those workers just 2 weeks after signing a contract. No wonder they're disappointed.
Well, finally, it was interesting to see the Liberals over there working the line yesterday. Buzz Hargrove gave that big embrace to Paul Martin. Where's the CAW lining up in terms of who are their real friends when it comes to these kinds of issues?
You know something? I'm not going to worry about that right now. Certainly the reception was friendly for me today. But I think what the people who are losing their jobs, who might be watching your show because they got laid off from a good job, are concerned about is not what party's doing what. They want the government of the country to react. And all I can say is we're going to put Mr. Harper's feet to the fire on this. We're going to stand with those workers who are concerned. And I just would encourage all Canadians to think about this Buy Canadian idea that's being promoted by the CAW and other unions. After all, it's our friends and neighbors down the street who are manufacturing the products, and we should focus on supporting them. So this is a key time for Canadians to get together around a core industry in our country and to support it. And I can just assure you the NDP will be doing that. And we'll be standing up against the Harper budget on Monday night because it gives another cross-the-board corporate tax cuts to banks and oil companies. They're not the ones that need the help right now, for heaven's sakes. And I
here I'd forgotten another chance to defeat the government. I'd forgotten all about it, of course, Monday night.
It comes on Monday night, and this has the immigration bill in it that's terrible. It has the theft of the EI surplus in it, which is the biggest theft in Canadian history, and it's going to get rubber stamped. I just hope that the Liberals show up and vote, and I invite Mr. Dion to join with me. If he thinks the finance minister should be fired, let's fire him together on Monday.
Jack Layton, fascinating as always. Thanks very much for joining us.
All righty, Mike.